I'm going to attempt to show me making the cloth-covered journal covers. I've never made them before. This is my first attempt at them. I've done a bunch of them now, so I've learned a few things, but let's see. So basically, you just cut your cloth to about, I would say, half an inch, three quarters of an inch, or an inch all around. This is probably a little small, but I'll do it anyway. Anyway, and just take your food packaging cover. Glue, in this case it's just, I think it's just regular school glue, it's like PVA, just like that, and I just put some glue in there, and a cheap kind of glue, and then I just took and put some drops of water in there and smooshed it around with my brush, and then that's what I'm using. And I learned this method from woman named Tammy Brackett, and she makes these, and I'll link her video on it in my YouTube channel, and she is the, her tutorial kind of gave me the idea that maybe I could do this as well. Because mostly I only ever painted my journal covers, or I've glued paper on there, pretty scrapbook paper, and that type of thing. But just thought that it's very, to me, it's very uncomfortable because my hands are sticky, everything's sticky from the glue, the corners are hard to put down and, or to make them look good. I wound up snipping those little corners off, and but anyway, I like the end result. So she just flips it over like that, and she makes sure to smooth it, which can be difficult as well because the, hang on one moment while I turn my radio off. I noticed that once the cloth gets wet from the glue, it will, some kinds of cloth will suddenly just stretch and you'll have ripples, and so it's a learning curve anyway, and but I enjoyed the process, sticky or not. And then basically you just go ahead and you can snip you can miter the corners like this, snip the little, snip that off if you wanted to. With that one I might not because it's quite small. Or maybe I will just for demonstration purposes, so snip a bit of it off. I guess I should have done that before I applied the glue. But if you just miter it like that on the corners, it helps to make the corners not so bulky. A bit easier to fold them in. Okay, so, and just like that. And if I had any tips for this, it'd be wherever the glue goes, the wet cloth goes as well. Okay, of course, while I was making this video, I got a phone call and text conversations from two different individuals. So I couldn't finish that, but that's okay because it gives me a chance to show you what it looks like after about 10 or 15 minutes with this cheap food packaging. It can buckle. And I also noticed that I can read what's underneath it. And then when I did watch the tutorial of Tammy's, she said that with some of the sheer cloth that you use, you may have to paint the food packaging white so that you don't see the wording underneath. But with this one, and I had done it with one of them, but with this one, I just thought that this cotton cloth was thick enough where it wouldn't do that. But that's okay, I'll figure out what to do. I have one side left to do, and I'll do it and give my pointers on that. And so basically spread that glue and get prepared to get your hands all sticky. Very difficult for me. I'm not really a severe neatnik, but I did find myself washing my hands a lot to wash all the glue off that was stuck on my hands. For some reason, I just really did not like that sticky feeling, and some of the threads in that were sticking on my fingers, and it was really weird. In any case, like I say, the wet cloth or wet sponge helps to clean up to where you don't have to go and wash your hands in the sink. Okay, just wanted to give that last tip here about these little tabs right here. At first I tried to tuck them in, I tried everything, but I find the best thing you can do is just to snip it off like that. And that just seems to neaten it up. Better. Hopefully I have given you some good tips about this, my experience with making cloth covered journal using food packaging, glue, and a tutorial off of YouTube. And it's been a lot of fun, really. It's been, took me out of my comfort zone about not having my hand all sticky. And there it is. And I've just basically left them. I just leave them to dry like that. And hopefully they will not buckle too badly. And if they do, I'll find some other way to straighten them out. Possibly an iron, possibly weight them with books. You know, there's a few other things we can do. Anyway, thanks so much for watching my attempt at this. If I think about it, I will maybe share one of the journals. I'm making a bunch of these for a craft fair, and I will share if I think about it. Alrighty, bye.